political power, but they were also the worst in terms of spiritual devotion to the Lord. So I believe that if the chronicler was here today, if he was living in our times and in our days right here and decided to journal about America, I believe that he would likewise write a book, and it would have to be split up into a few chapters, amen, amen, that would say that you are a very wealthy country, America. It would also say that you are certainly very famous. People all around the world want to come and not only visit, but want to come and relocate and live in America. Amen. I believe it would also say that they would boast of our great political power. We have a great political system. Amen. A democracy where people can have their voice be heard. We have a right to vote. We have a lot of rights in this country. But I believe that the chronicle will also say, but where is your spiritual devotion to the Lord? Amen. Because although America is great, we know we've been built on the foundations of God, but over time we have allowed other gods, small g's, to come in and start to try and reinstitute the principles and the concepts of the true and living God. Amen. So I believe the chronicler would say to us today, where is your spiritual devotion to the Lord? So verse number one, it says, then the Spirit of God came upon Azariah, the son of Oded. So we see here that what happened to Azariah, who was a prophet, he was a prophet of God, and this also not only happened to Azariah, but it also happened to all of the chosen of God in that day. The Bible says that, it said that the Spirit of God came upon Azariah. And we know that back in the Old Testament, that the Spirit of God came upon people when it led them to speak and to share a message and to share a word with the people of God. It was not until Jesus ascended but that he began to say to the disciples he said that the Spirit of God will come upon, he said that he would send the Spirit of God, the Comforter, to comfort us and to be with us. Amen. So I am so thankful today that I know that it was meaningful and purposeful during the time of the Old Testament when the Spirit of God resting on people to give them a word. But I'm so glad, amen, that the word tells us that the Spirit of God dwells in us. Amen. Amen. That the Comforter is in us. That the Advocate is in us and is advocating to the Father for us. Amen. I am so glad, hallelujah, that the Counselor walks with us. So when we are down, the Holy Spirit will counsel us. Amen. So that the soul and everything will be all right. I am so glad, amen, that the Comforter is with us, because when we are boo-hooing in our own, whatever we may be dealing with, the Comforter will let us know it's all right. I am with you always, even until the end of the ages. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So that's 1 Corinthians, amen, chapter 3, verse 16 says that, don't you know, don't you realize that you are the temple of God and that the Holy Spirit dwells in you? Thank you, Jesus. So I'm so glad that we know, we're thankful for the prophets of old that the Spirit of God came upon, but I'm so glad that the Spirit of God dwells in us. Amen. Amen. So verse 2 says, the Spirit of God came upon him, and he went out to meet King Asa as he was returning from the battle. Asa was a good king. He desired to do what was pleasing in the sight of God. You know, they went through so many kings that were evil. But we thank God that there were some kings that came along that refused to bow to a small g god. They refused to allow the people to come in and to corrupt their minds and to corrupt their cities. So King Asa was a good king. And when Prophet Azariah came to him, he heeded the word of the Lord. We got to hear that, because sometimes the word of the Lord is going forth, but we're not heeding to what God is saying. So King Asa, as he was returning from battle, he came and he said, listen to me, Asa. He shouted. The prophet shouted because he wanted him to know that this is a serious matter. I need you to really hear what I'm trying to say. Perhaps if I have come and a less loud, or if I wasn't shouting, maybe he would not have heard me. But I'm going to go and shout, because I really want King Asa to hear what I have to say. Not only to King Asa, but he said, listen, all you people of Judah and Benjamin, amen, because because not only was he shouting to the king, but he was also shouting to the people. Yeah. God don't only speak to the pastor, to the preacher, but he also speaks to the members. Yeah. Amen. Because he wants all of us to get the word, because all of us one day will have to stand for ourselves. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. So listen, Asa, King Asa, he shouted, listen, all you people of Judah and Benjamin, the Lord will stay with you as long as you stay with him.
Amen.
Whenever you seek him, you will find him. But if you abandon him, he will abandon you. Now, we know that the Lord desires to stay and remain in fellowship with every single one of us. And I love that he says that the Lord will stay with you as long as you stay with him. God's desire is that we stay with him. That we don't turn away from him, because God is God, whether we are with him or whether we turn around and go any other direction, he's still God. Amen. He's still a great God, whether we are with him or whether we are have turned and went in the other direction. But God's desire is that we will stay with him and walk along with him, that we will be guided by him, that we will listen and heed to his instructions. So whenever he said you seek him, you will find him. I love that, amen, because it lets us know that God ain't hard to find.
Right.
If you're looking for him, if you're really seeking for him, you shall find him. Some people think that looking for God, I can't find him. You may be not, maybe you're not looking in the right place, amen. But if you're looking for God, if you're seeking him, if you're seeking a word from the Lord, you will find him, amen. So his desire is for us to be in close communion with him, to be in close relationship and fellowship with him. Amen. But when he is trying to comfort us, when he is trying to help us and to lead us and to guide us, and when he's trying to walk alongside us and we refuse to allow him to be God in our life, amen, God will stand right here while you walk off. But one thing I love about God, while he's here and you've walked away, he's still here. And when you get over there, wherever you're trying to go, he's over there too. Amen. And that is encouraging for us. Amen. Because we know that no matter where we go, we can't get out of the presence or the realm of God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Because sometimes in our life, we are, I'm not at the same place even for us. I'm not, before I was talking about those who are not in Christ who have turned and walked away. But now even for us who are in the Lord, sometimes we are up here in the spirit, worshiping and praising and praying and reading the word of God. And sometimes we kind of start dropping down a little bit. Amen. But the same God, amen, that was with us when we was up here on the top, shouting, praising, and running around, when stuff hit out like this, and we come down and we may not praying as much or fasting as much or reading the word as much, he is still right there. He's still the same God, amen, that desires to draw us even closer to him. Thank you, Jesus. But verse 3 says, for a long time, Israel was without the true God, without a priest to teach them, and without the law to instruct them. For a long time, another translation says, for a season, that Israel was without God. Oh, it must have been a horrible, dark place to be without God. It must have been a sad situation to be without God. And I tell you, I don't care what we do, what this world does. We, as the saints of God, better make sure we do all we can so God does not exit from this land.
Yes,
what a sad place it would be without God. And that's the same way we have to think about people that we come in contact with that are without God.
Right.
There are people that are on our jobs that are without God.
Yes.
There are people in our families that are without God. So, and God calls us to pray for them. Mm. And not only pray for them, but we have to speak life in their life, into their atmosphere, into their world. Amen.
Yes.
We have to, the Bible says we are able to call those things as not as though they were. Amen. We have to call those things as not as though they were. When we see somebody, when we see somebody and they're not acting like a man of God, we have to say, hello, man of God.
That's right.
Hello, man of God.
That's right.
Hello,
woman of God.
Hello, woman of God.
Hello.
Because see, that's a little, after a while, the flesh may not want to receive, but the spirit man will catch that thing.
Yeah.
Hello, man of God, woman of God. to speak that stuff into people's life, and not only to other people, but you got to speak it in your own life.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
When stuff don't look like it's going the way that God designed for it to in your life, you got to say, oh, I'm the head. I'm still the head and not the tail.
Right.
I'm still above and I'm not beneath. Hallelujah. I'm still blessed in the city. This city that I'm in right now is so holy and I'm blessed in it. I'm blessed in the field. I'm getting ready to go out and I'm blessed. Hallelujah. I'm going to come in right now and I'm still blessed. We have got to be able to speak those things over our life. Amen. We've got to know that God has given to us the power and the authority to speak and call those things as not as though they were.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that again. He gives us the power, the scripture says, and the authority. Now see, this, the word of God is where everything stands.
Yes.
The scripture said that we can call those things that are not as though they were. So I don't know what is not in your life right now. I want you to take a moment and think about it. I don't know what's not in your life right now, but I want you to think about it and in your mind call it as it was. Hallelujah. Call it as what God has called it in the beginning of the world. Hallelujah. If it ain't saved, you call it saved. If it's not delivered, you call it delivered. If it hasn't been set free, you say it's set free. If it hasn't been blessing and running over in your finances, you call it blessed running over in your finances. Whatever it is, God said call those things that are not as though they were. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Jesus.
So verse 4, it says, but whenever they were in trouble, they turned to the Lord, the God of Israel, and sought him out. They found him. Whenever they pushed God to the side, whenever they pushed him to the side, and whenever they were in trouble, you know what happens. Sometimes when we're not in trouble, when everything is going well, everything is on W-E-L-L in our life, it's going good and it's all nice, and we don't pray as much. We don't often fast as much or study the word as much. Sometimes stuff will begin to lighten up. But it says right here in verse 4, but whenever trouble rose in their life, the Bible says there's nothing new under the sun. Amen. So when trouble rose in their life, just like when trouble rises up in our life, then we're down at the altar, oh God, help me, Jesus. Lord, if you can get me out of this. Lord, if you can fix this situation right here, I know that everything will be all right. Amen. But whenever they were in trouble, they turned to the Lord. But I'm glad that happened to them and that it happens to us, because we all know that, thank God, that there's a place we can turn when we are in trouble. Amen. There's a rock that we can turn to when we are in trouble. Come on. There's a hill that we can look to when we are in trouble. Amen. There's a lily in the valley when we are in trouble. Come on. So I'm so glad that he will also be a bridge over the troubled waters when we are in trouble. I'm so glad that we serve God, that even when we are in trouble, he is right there. Thank you, Jesus. So they pushed God to the side because they were prospering. They pushed God to the side because they were wealthy. They pushed God to the side because they were politically strong. But I'm so glad that we too, when we are in our folly, when we are in our mess, when we are thinking we are wealthy in our own selves, when we are thinking that we have our own little bit of fame or whatever that may be, I am so glad, amen, that God will still look upon us, amen. I'm so glad that when we call on him, we'll find him. When we seek him, we know that he will be found by us. Even when we're in our quiet time, we'll be able to find him. When we're in our prayer time, when we're fasting and in worship, we will still be able to find our great God. Hallelujah. And not only will we be able to find him, amen, but we will also be able to find, when we are walking in real connection with the Lord, we'll be able to find new levels and new depths in the spirit realm with our God. Amen. Don't you realize that where you are right now is not all that God has for you in the spirit realm?
Yes,
amen. There are some gifts that God has for you that you haven't even overturned
yet. That's right.
Amen. Yeah. But there are some blessings God has for you that you haven't even seen. It tells us in Jeremiah 33, and there's some stuff that God has for you that you don't even know anything about.
Yes.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. There's a new level of even faith in him. A new level of mercies that are found in our God. Hallelujah. But God desires, amen, that we walk with him so he can reveal those things to us, reveal those gifts to us, and reveal the new places that he has for us in the spirit. Amen. That there's somebody in the room right now that God has called to lay hands on somebody and to heal the sick. Come on now. There's somebody right in the room that God has called a prophet or a prophetess to prophesy unto the nations. Come, there's somebody in here right now that God is calling to be a bishop or an apostle. We don't know, but I know that when we start, the Bible says for us to stir up the gifts of God within us. Amen. You never know what God has in store for you. That's why you can't sit on the gifts of God. Because as you begin to stir up one gift, God will begin to reveal some of the other gifts that he has in store for you. Amen. So verse number 5, it says, during those dark times, it was not safe to travel. There was no peace, nowhere to be found. Problems trouble people of every land. It said, nation fought against nation, city against city. Amen. They couldn't even travel because it was unsafe. The place that they lived and dwelled in, it wasn't even a safe place to travel. Amen. Can you imagine thinking that whenever you walk out your door, that safety is not around you, that you are afraid to even go anywhere because of the attacks that might break out around you? So they was living in a very tight place, amen. And it can be likened to some of the cities right here in America that are in, some people call them hoods, amen, that have gunfire and those kind of things going on, drugs and et cetera, and gangs, and that the people who live in those communities don't feel safe. Right. Trying to get from one place to the other. Right. They're having to watch and look out and calculate who is where and where who is going and where somebody is coming from. I can tell you very well from experience, amen, of growing up in the city of New York. Amen. It wasn't always that way, but one morning we woke up and crime was everywhere. Amen. Crime was evident everywhere. And I remember coming out the train station every day after work, having to look on which side to walk on, because the drug dealers, they were organized. Just like the enemy is organized with his camp, the drug dealers was organized. They would be having meetings, amen, trying to figure out what street they was going to overtake and where they was going to go next. I would have to come out saying, on what side are they having a meeting on, so I would know what side I need to walk on. So it means a lot when you are living in a place that don't feel safe. So it says here that during those times it wasn't even safe to travel. There was no peace, and problems troubled the people of every land. Nation against nation, city against city. Then it says, for God was troubling them with every kind of problem. I'm going to read that again. It says, for God. Who was troubling them?
God.
They said God was troubling them with every kind of trouble. Do you know if this nation think you're going to take God out of school and pray out of school and God off the money and God out of this country? Let me tell you something. God will bring trouble in this land. Amen. God can bring. It didn't say that the devil brought. It said God brought the trouble in the land. So we got to pray for this nation. We got to pray, amen, that God will be the God that he is. Amen. That he don't have to bow down to the rules and the policies of this nation, but rather that the rules and this nation and the policies will bow down to our God. God can bring trouble in this land if this land refuses to obey what he is saying. Amen. And not only can God bring trouble and any kind of problem to the land, but he'll bring trouble to our house. And we're not being obedient. Come on now, you know what he did to Jonah. He told Jonah, I need you to go down to Nineveh, because he said people down there that need to be saved. But Jonah, with his bad self, said, I'm not going down. He didn't tell God, but in his mind, he said, my feet going this way, because I really don't want to see that people saved. Right. I'm going right over here to someplace else, and I'm going to do something over there when I get there. But God brought trouble to his land. And not only did God bring trouble to his land, to him personally, for him being disobedient, but do you know the people that was on the boat with him almost safe as well? You remember that?
Amen.
Amen. So I want us to see that today, that not only can you cause some trouble to ripple in your atmosphere in your house, Amen. By you being disobedient, but it works the opposite. You can also bring blessings. Amen. Liken to the curses that will happen, blessings will come to your house when you are being obedient to God. Amen. Blessings will come to your job when you are being obedient to God because you are there. Blessings will come to your family because you are obedient and because you are a servant of God in the midst of them. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So sometimes God will bring trouble because of disobedience. When people forget him, but I'm glad that King Asa, he brought about a time where people began to return once again to God. Amen. Verse 7 said, but as for you, be strong and courageous, for your work will be rewarded. Amen. Be strong and be courageous, as the Message Bible said, because payday is coming. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I tell you, I get excited right there.
Amen.
That's running news right there.
Amen.
And I said a praise goes right there that payday is coming.
Yes.
I don't know if you all remember that are here, those who, well, some may not remember, but some of you may. But in 1986, anyone that had a foot in partying and in the club scene, I might remember that Johnny Kemp, along with Aaron Hall and Ted Riley, they wrote a song called Just Got Paid. Anybody remember it? Just got paid. Friday night. Money in my pocket. Come on now, y'all remember? They wrote a song called Just Got Paid. It's Friday night. Money in my pocket. And you know, I don't know about you, but I get excited when payday shows up. Amen. I be looking forward to payday. Amen. I was on a bus riding home from work, and the bus was very late. And so people got on, and someone was kind of grumbling. So the bus driver was trying to make it a good day for everybody. He said, good afternoon. And, he never said anything about being late because he knew everybody's kind of upset. So he said, well, at least it's payday. And one lady said, yeah, it's payday, but that don't matter because that's all owed out to somebody else anyway. But for the rest of us, amen, I was so glad that it was payday, amen. I was excited that not every one of my dollars was owed out to somebody. Thank you, Jesus. So, amen. So the songwriter said, I just got paid. It's Friday night. I just got paid. I got money in my pocket. I'm feeling all right.
Amen.
So, although Johnny wrote this song, and it was very popular in 1986, millions of people today still get paid when payday is coming. Amen. Many people get excited because for many it means that you're going to have money in your pocket, you can pay your bills,
right.
You can do some other stuff that you desire to do. Some companies require their employees to wait 1 week before their payday arrives. Some companies require their employees to wait bi-weekly before payday arrives. And there are other companies who require that their employees to wait a month before payday arrives. But in most instances, it doesn't matter when people receive their paycheck or when their paycheck arrives. All we know that people are excited that payday is on the way.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
So can you imagine this morning, King Asa, how he felt when the prophet told him to hold on because he was going to be rewarded by God?
Yeah.
To hold on, be courageous, because payday was on the way. And the same God that sent the message to Asa is sending that message to you and me as well on today. God is saying, hold on and don't give up because you are about to be rewarded. The same God who said to Asa to hold on is the same God that is saying to us today to hold on. I want to let you know that payday is coming. And he's about to pay you what is due to you. Amen. I heard a song that said, it's a church song that said that payday is coming after a while. Amen. So you better get ready.
Yeah.
faithful. Because you were waiting on your God, God said the payday is coming. He's going to bless your household. Why? Because you've been faithful to him. In the midst of whatever's going on in your house, you've still been faithful. You've still been calling on the name of the Lord. You've still been praying. You've still been putting your plate down fasting. So because of that, God said your payday is coming. So all you need to do is just hold on. God says hold on a little while longer because your payday is coming. Somebody tell your neighbor, your payday is on the way. Your payday is coming. And your pay for God is on the way. I'm so glad that God, he said he's seen your tears. He heard your disappointment. He knows what you've been sharing with people. Saying, you know, I thought it would be different by now. I thought this thing would look different than what it looked, but you still been faithful. And God said, because you have been faithful to him, that your payday is on the way. Hallelujah. So he said, don't you worry. He said, don't you fear. But he said that we need to stop fretting because payday is on the way. So be strong. God said to take heart now and don't lose hope for what you've been believing and for because your payday, it is on the way. Don't you lose hope. You've been believing God for some great stuff and it may not have come when you thought it should have come. But God, when he shows up with your payday, is always on time. So your payday is coming. So you continue to be encouraged. You continue to wait on the Lord and know that in store for you. And just like your paycheck, it has your name written on it. Come on now. Just like your paycheck, it has your name written on it. And I'll tell you one thing, that I can't cash Tammy's check. Because if I go somewhere trying to cash your check, that's illegal. And I can go to jail. So can't nobody cash my paycheck. And can't nobody cash yours. So you ought to get excited. Your payday, it is on the way. Put your hands together and give God some praise. Come on, if you believe your payday is coming, I'm going to give him a greater praise than that. Your payday is on the way. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God, we bless you. God, we thank you. We thank you, God, just in knowing that because we have been faithful, because we have been looking to you for everything that we need. Yeah. Because we have put our hope and our trust in you. Amen. Yeah. I am so excited in knowing, amen, that you will reward us. Yeah. That you will give us what is our due according to your blessings. Right. And because you will give us our due, amen, we can put that in. We can cash. That's a check we can cash. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. That payday is on the way. Yeah. Amen. Can we give God some praise?